Okay, so now that we had the look on the most popular search engines on the darknet, or that we can use to discover hidden services, in this lecture, I want to show you more ways to discover hidden services or onion services. And we'll do this using websites that link us to other websites or to other services. Now, like I said, there are a number of ClearNet websites that link you to hidden services. All you have to do is just look for them in DuckDuckGo or even in Google. A very popular website that lists a number of links is the Hidden Wiki. You can look for it on any search engine. I have the link for it right here, so I'm just going to copy and paste it here. Now, the Hidden Wiki will contain a lot of broken links and a lot of scam, so you want to be very careful when you click in on links here. I'm showing it here to you for the sake of completion, because you might find some useful links in here, and if you're a security researcher, you really need to know what the Hidden Wiki is, even know about the scammy websites in here, because you might want to do research on them, or you might want to investigate them. Using this is very simple. You can see categories. Each category contains websites that fall under this category. You can copy and paste the links to access them. It's as simple as that. A better website with more valid links would be Dark.Fail. So the Dark.Fail is a ClearNet domain that you can access on any browser. Or if you're on the Tor browser, you can access the hidden service for this website. So again, copy-pasting it in here in my Tor browser. This will load a website similar to the Hidden Wiki, so it contains a number of links to popular hidden services. And these links are PGP verified, so it's less likely to be scam. And it's all valid links, so you can see the grayed out ones. These are links that are offline. So for example, if you try to access this link right here, it won't work. Everything else, it should work. So this is different to what's in the Hidden Wiki. You'll notice this if you test it yourself. You'll see a lot of the links that you click in the Hidden Wiki will not actually work. Another place where you can get hidden services is the DeepNet or the DeepWeb subreddit. So this is actually a subreddit on the ClearNet Reddit. So again, you can access it using a normal browser or using the Tor browser. Obviously, it's better to access it using the Tor browser because you'll be more anonymous. And in here, you'll see all sorts of topics about the deep web. So you'll see people discussing anonymity, people discussing new services, new vulnerabilities, and so on. So if you're a Reddit user, or even if you're not a Reddit user, but you want to use the DeepNet frequently, then this is a really good subreddit to stay updated with. And like I said, it'll also contain a number of good entry points. So you'll see if there is any new websites, if there is any new deep web search engines, and so on. Another useful subreddit similar to deep web is onions. So again, reddit.com/r/onions. Again, in here, you'll find links to hidden services to onion websites and updates and news about vulnerabilities and about what's new in the darknet. On top of this, a really good place to get links would be forums or people that you start, now when you start contacting or you start talking to through messaging apps or through emails, and we'll talk about how to use messaging apps and emails later on in the course. Now I also want to mention two other websites that I think could be useful, and I don't want to spend a full lecture on them in the future. The first one is Dread, which is a Reddit for the DeepNet. So I'm just going to copy paste its link. Now like I said, keep in mind, if any of these links don't work, just use one of the search engines that I showed you in the previous lecture to search for the website name. So if you paste this link in here and it doesn't work, all you have to do is just look for a Dread, onion link or onion service in one of the search engines that I showed you in the previous lecture, and you should be able to find its link. So as you can see, this is a website that has a very similar style to Reddit. You have a number of subreddits in here or subdreads. And in it, you can post or you can upvote, downvote. So the usage of this website is very, very similar to Reddit. The only thing is you can discuss DeepNet or onion services related topics in here. Last but not least, I also want to show you hidden answers. Now, this is similar to Quora or other websites where you can ask a question and get an answer too. Again, the only difference in here, first of all, it's more private, it's more anonymous, and you can ask questions related to onion services or to the deep web. So that's it for this lecture. Just wanted to cover more entry points that you can use to discover other onion services or deepnet websites. Like I said, the main thing to keep in mind is the links for these websites could change, and you might try something that I've used here and it wouldn't work for you. If it doesn't, just look for the website name. Forget about the URL. Look for the website name. For example, if you're looking for hidden answers, look for hidden answers in DuckDuckGo or in any other search engine that I covered in the previous lecture. And from there, you should be able to find a valid link for this particular hidden service. Sometimes you could find a direct link, so a direct onion link, or in other cases, you might find a ClearNet website or another DeepNet website that will link you to this. So the steps are simple. Look for the website name in a search engine. From there, you'll either find a direct link or another website that will link you to this hidden service.